Good afternoon, and welcome to this winter concert of the North Oakland Concert Band. And yes, we do know it's winter out there. Thanks for braving the weather and coming out to help us celebrate another concert in the 40th season of the NOCB. My name is Mark Buchanan. I'm the president of the band and also a member of the trumpet section. We have a great program for you today. First, I'd like to just do some housekeeping. In the lobby, you probably saw the table where you could purchase CDs of the NOCB, as well as you could buy Dave Bennett CDs as well. So those are now set up out there. Check it out at intermission if you'd like to buy some CDs of Dave Bennett. We greatly and very much appreciate your generous donations. Without your support of the band, it would be difficult to bring in all the fabulous musicians that we have here today, as well as to purchase the music. So thank you again very much for donating. If you'd like to get on our mailing list to stay up to date on the latest concert, we have a form, a card you can fill out, and we'll get you on our mailing list, email list, and send you the latest information of upcoming concerts. Finally, just like me here, turn off your cell phone or put it on silent. We'd appreciate that. Okay, so to get started, the Cambrian period of our planet's geological history, which was about 500 million years ago, saw an explosion of plant and animal diversity evolving into many of the life forms and flora and fauna we have today. An explosion of music forms and surprises are presented in our first piece today, entitled Cambrian Explosion by Richard Saucedo. Also, listen for the familiar hymn, For the Beauty of the Earth, which is woven into the complexity of the piece. So I'd like to introduce our conductor, Annette Klein.
What a great way to start off the afternoon with that Cambrian explosion. I'm Robin Myers. I'm one of the flutists in the North Oakland Concert Band, and I will be your program moderator for the rest of the concert. When released in 1991, Beauty and the Beast marked a turning point for Walt Disney Pictures by appealing to millions of fans with its Oscar-winning musical score by lyricist Howard Ashman and composer Alan Menken. The Disney animated picture has morphed through the years to a full-blown stage play to the most recent live-action film, which premiered in 2017. The music is timeless and has been performed by such musical greats as Celine Dion, Peebo Bryson, Josh Groban, Ariana Grande, and John Legend. The original Broadway production ran for over 13 years and was nominated for 9 Tony Awards, including Best Musical. It has also been produced in 37 countries worldwide. While composing the orchestral score that accompanies the film's prologue, Alan Menken was inspired by the French suite The Carnival of Animals by Camille Saint-Saëns, referring to it as his own version of Saint-Saëns' composition. Menken believes that all properly structured musicals should feature an I Want song because they're essentially about a character having a big dream and then running into some obstacle to that quest. We invite you to step into the enchanted world of Disney's modern classic, Beauty and the Beast, where appearances are not always what they seem.
Thank you.
Are you ready for this next one? Because we are. Spartacus is in the house. The prolific and internationally admired Belgian composer, Jan van der Roest, is represented here in our next composition, which is very different in style and inspiration. His much-admired tone poem, Spartacus, is an homage to Respighi, whose sense of color and imagination have long fascinated van der Roest. When composing Spartacus, he never intended the music to be based on a concrete story. Spartacus was actually a true person. He hailed from Greece and was a fierce Thracian gladiator who was one of the escaped slave leaders in the Third Civil War, a major slave uprising against the Roman Republic. Little is known about Spartacus because the events of the war and the surviving historical accounts are sometimes contradictory and may not always be reliable. However, all sources agree that he was a former gladiator and an accomplished military leader. Sit back and enjoy this dramatic work as the NOCB transports you back to 111 to 71 BC, where you might recognize and hear the grandeur and magnificence of films such as Ben-Hur, Quo Vadis, and Spartacus.
Thank you.
Didn't I tell you Spartacus was in the house? We will now take a 10-minute intermission. See you back in 10. Welcome back to our second half, and you are so in for an awesome treat. I can't even tell you, I'm so excited. But our first piece in the second half is one of Sousa's most unusual marches, and it was written in 1928, and that it departed considerably from his customary observance of traditional march forms. Rarely had he attempted to color his marches with borrowed tunes, feeling that an appropriate title on a good solid march was all that he needed to provide. This march was originally called the Queen of the Plateau before being given its present title of the New Mexico March. It was dedicated to Governor R.C. Dillon and the people of that state and was reportedly written at the governor's request. Listen now as our next piece begins with the customary Sousa March style, then launches into a musical history of New Mexico with the music of the Native Americans, the Calvary, the Mexicans, and includes hints of the state song, O Fair New Mexico, that was written by Elizabeth Garrett. Georgia on My Mind is a song by Hoagy Carmichael and Stuart Burrell, closely associated with a cover version by Ray Charles, a native of Georgia, who recorded it for his 1960 album, The Genius Hits the Road. It became the official state song of the state of Georgia in 1979. To make this selection even more special this afternoon, we have a great honor and pleasure to welcome a clarinet prodigy who hails from Waterford Township, the great Dave Bennett, back to our stage. If you've never heard or seen Dave Bennett perform, you are in for the treat of your lives. Dave is known around the world for his tributes to the swing era, as well as rockabilly and country, and not only plays clarinet, but electric guitar, piano, and drums, and is known also to vocalize as well. He has been a featured soloist at Carnegie Hall with the New York Hops in 2013, and has played with at least 35 other U.S. and Canadian orchestras, including our very own Detroit Symphony Orchestra. You can often catch a local performance of Dave at Billy's Tippin' Inn or the Dirty Dog Jazz Cafe, or sometimes at the Grand Hotel on Mackinac Island during Jazz Festival over select Labor Day weekends. To perform Georgia on My Mind, please, please help me welcome to the, for the third time, the live performance of Dave Bennett. Welcome, Dave. Thank you.
Thank you very much, everybody. It is a real pleasure to be here once again. As we were saying, this is my third time performing with the North Oakland Concert Band, and they're a fantastic group of musicians and even more fantastic group of people. I just want to thank you for being so kind to me to let me perform with you tonight. Just by a quick show of hands, how many of you have either seen us before or this is your first time? That's great. I always like to get a feel for how this is going to go. But the really cool thing about today is we are debuting two original pieces of music that I wrote for concert band. And we released a new album on Mack Avenue Records about a year and a half ago. And I'm very grateful to say that it went to number 24 on the Billboard Jazz chart last year. So we're very excited. Things are going along real good. But to join us on these next couple of songs that come from the album, I'd like to welcome my good friend and arranger of the two songs you're going to hear right now, Mr. Jeff Kressler at the piano. Jeff and I spend about 80% of our lives traveling on the road. And I remember, Jeff, remember when I met your mother-in-law, and the first thing she said to me was, "So you're the one keeping my son away from home all the time." So it's the band that are getting in trouble. But we'd like to play an original song for you right now. And this is the title track off of our new album. This is called Blood Moon. Thank you. So we're going to play one more song that is featured on the new album. And if you're interested, after the show, we will be selling our recordings out in the lobby. We have lovely Mandy, who has volunteered graciously to sell our merchandise. She's taken a leave of absence from the convent this weekend to help us. And we'd be more than happy to autograph any merchandise you'd like. Just keep in mind that when we do that, it reduces the value by about 13%. So we hope you enjoy this next one. This is called Falling Sky.
Thank you.
Don't you feel like you were just at a club? You need a drink passed around. Thanks so much, Dave. Granted, no two clarinetists, or five or ten, could really rearticulate the musical genius of Artie Shaw. When band leader Artie Shaw put down his clarinet in 1954, vowing never to play again, he made a forever decision most of us could never contemplate. He had been the number one band leader in the world and had recorded countless tunes that were considered then and will be thought of as always as classics. Along with one or two other names, none ranked higher as an innovator on his instrument. The reluctant star who died at the age of 94, and he was ranked among the most gifted and accomplished artists to pick up the instrument during the 20th century. All good things must come to an end, and sadly, this concert is no different. We have been honored and blessed to have Dave Bennett join us this afternoon, and humbled to have spent the afternoon with all of you, our cherished audience members. We would also like to thank you for your donations and your continued support so that we can continue to hold concerto competitions and bring you quality programming featuring soloists like Dave. We hope you can join us at our next fundraiser, held next month at the Orion Community Center on Sunday, March 24th at 4 p.m. And for the final time this afternoon, please welcome Dave Bennett back to the stage for his rendition of Artie Shaw's Concerto for Clarinet. Thank you.